Hello, I'm Anne Weiser-Cornell, and this is Support for Stressful Times. Do you feel the times are stressful? Are you feeling stressed these days? I feel stressed. I feel people are stressed. When I go to the market, the supermarket, there's a sense of tension there. When I drive, I feel tension in the way other people are driving. I think there's more stress out there than when I was younger. And what matters right now is you. How are you feeling? Because this is support for stressful times. So I want to be present with you and help you be present to yourself in the way that can give you the most support, emotional support, support from the community that we have here together in this webinar. And from your support from your own body. Isn't that nice to be able to tap into that support, even when things are stressful? So let's take a breath together. Take your own breath, whatever it is. And I'll just invite you to take a moment with me right now. To feel your body. To feel your body resting on support. So probably you're sitting, although it's okay if you're lying down or standing. Whatever you're doing, your body is getting support from what it's resting on. Even if you're walking, every step has support under it, right? Most people are sitting, as I am. And we're gonna pause a moment together and just feel that, because it's easy to ignore the body and the source of support that you can get from your body. So let's pause together right now and just have a sense of support. I love to feel my feet. I sort of wiggle my toes, shuffle my feet a bit, and I'm quite aware of my feet. So much support comes through the feet. Is that true for you too? Just notice. And then I find myself bringing awareness to my buttocks or sit bones or seat or whatever you want to call that area, the hips. A lot of sitting happens there. And I feel that right now. You might find you want to move around a little to be a little more comfortable. Put a pillow behind you or stretch a little. Sure. That's your body telling you what it needs to feel more grounded, more supported, more comfortable. That's great. And then there's your breath. Breath is part of what supports you, isn't it? I mean, for many people it is. Noticing whether it's that way for you. Find myself breathing naturally, but when I bring awareness to my breath, it kind of deepens. And noticing if it's that way for you. So we're finding ourselves resting on support and bringing extra attention to that support right now. Great. And the next place I'd like to invite you is to the inner area of your body. So that inner area, your throat, chest, stomach, belly. You can call it your abdomen or solar plexus. Names don't matter for this. It's this inner area. Bring an awareness in here to sense, how am I right now? Your body is always ready to tell you how you are. Like an inner weather report. How's my inner weather right now? Wow, I just noticed something. As soon as I said the word weather, I felt tension in my stomach. That's interesting. So you might also be aware of something in your inner body feeling tense, heavy, some other perhaps uncomfortable feeling. Let's welcome that. That's a radical thing to do, isn't it? Because I grew up, my training was, if you feel something uncomfortable, ignore it, push it away, look for something more cheerful. The idea of turning toward what feels uncomfortable is just amazing to me. I started to do that in my 20s when I met my mentor, Eugene Gendlin. Turn toward. Eugene Gendlin has this beautiful thing he said. I'm going to type it in the chat, actually. It's this: every bad feeling is potential energy for a more right way of being. If you give it space to move toward its rightness. Oh my gosh, every bad feeling, no exceptions. 100% every bad feeling is potential energy toward a more right way of being. When there's something in your body that feels bad, like painful, stressful, tight, heavy, clenching, that has a gift for you. It knows something. One thing it knows is that there's something you need that you might not be getting right now. Well, it's good to know if there's something we need. It's good to know. So I found, when I said the word weather, I found a kind of a tight clenching in my stomach came right there. It's still there a bit. Here in Northern California, we've been having some pretty intense weather. We're not alone in that. A lot of people in the world, Northern Hemisphere especially, having pretty intense weather right now. So I'm acknowledging, I didn't realize that there was something in me having a tightness reaction to the weather. Sunny day right now. So it's not about the present circumstance. It's more like a tensing up in anticipation of more hard weather coming, the scariness that can mean, the uncertainty. As I say this to you right now, I'm also acknowledging it inside. And I invite you to notice, where are those tightnesses and uncomfortable places in you right now that might need you to listen for a while to what that's about? Yeah? Every bad feeling is potential energy toward a more right way of being, if you give it space to move toward its rightness. When we bring attention, when we bring awareness to what we're feeling, that is giving it space. The kind of awareness that gives space to an uncomfortable feeling is one that just says, okay, there you are. So if I tried to make it go away, if I tried to talk it out, don't feel so bad, it's a sunny day, that's not giving it space. But if I take time to be with it, if I welcome it, if I say, okay, that's how you're feeling, huh? And then I say, tell me more. So I'm inviting the uncomfortable place I feel inside to tell me more what it is that's feeling this way for it. Now, when I say tell me more, I don't mean it's going to start talking to me. You know that, right? I don't mean it's going to start talking to me. It's going to, it's hard to describe. There will be more. There's an invitational space, and more comes in that invitational space. I realize, oh, it's not that there's bad weather right now. It's something about the uncertainty. Will there be high winds? Will there be power outages? Will there be floods? I don't know. Something is having a hard time not knowing that. Okay. So you can be spending time sensing the place that doesn't feel so good and inviting it to show you more, reveal more. It might do that with images, memories. Often our body speaks to us in emotions. And then let it know you hear it. Because when something comes from inside, the very next thing it needs is to be met, right? If you're going to communicate with somebody, you want them to receive your communication. So your body's talking to you. It's showing you things. It's mine is getting tight in the stomach. I want to say, yeah, I hear you. I hear that there's something about the uncertainty around the weather. It's feeling kind of hard these days. Now, let me take a moment to do that. Okay. Did you try that too? Let it know you hear it. What I noticed was a little bit of, like my shoulders went down, my breath deepened, as if this place down here, the one with the tightness, is so glad I heard it. It's really glad to be heard. Well, what are you noticing? I'd love to hear in the chat what you've become aware of in your body, what's going on in your life that feels stressful or hard. And as you think about writing something like that, let me also say that there is a kind of language. If you've been with me before, you're familiar with this language. It really makes a nice big difference. So I didn't say, I'm tense about the weather. I said, something in me is tense about the weather. And this something in me allows a relationship where I can be with it. I am sensing. Yeah, say that too. I am sensing something in me is da da da. And it's really, really nice because it's not pushing it away. It's not trying to manipulate it. You know, I'm afraid that there's a lot of methods out there that are doing their best for people and actually do help many people, but they do something that I wouldn't agree with. And that is they do things to your process. They have you do things to your process. Talk to it, negotiate with it, tell it everything is going to be okay. What I think really helps is to say, I'm here and I hear you. And the reason that's so amazing is that it trusts the process itself. The thing that got tight in my stomach, it knows how to be not tight. I don't have to explain that to it. I'm not wiser than my body. My job is to be here and listen and be present. And then it knows how to take its next steps. I love it. And I think I'm in awe that those other methods work so well, because I do think when we do things to our process, it slows things down, because it expresses a kind of lack of trust. Let's see what people are writing in the chat. Heather writes, I observe that panicky part because becomes stronger. It's about finance, etc. Yeah, something in you is feeling panicky about finance and that kind of thing. And it, as you were with it, you observed it become stronger. Yeah. You know, that happens. One of the things that happens when we are with our feelings is they go, yeah, no. Well, that's because somebody's listening. And so I think it's actually a good sign when things get stronger. It's a sign they know you're here. Sue writes, I'm sensing something in my chest that feels a deep sadness. Yeah, beautiful. With that kind of language, you're able to be with the place, the something that feels that sadness. Hope writes, I'm sensing something in me is feeling fragile. And I know that Hope has had a skiing accident and had an operation. And so no wonder something's feeling fragile. And so that's another nice thing you can say to yourself is no wonder. Because it is a way of validating that your feelings make sense. Stacy writes, something in me is afraid everything's slipping from my fingers as soon as I touch it. Okay. So that place is letting you know what it fears is true. And that's very important to let it know you hear its fears. We don't know. Because for that part of you, it feels like things are slipping from your fingers as soon as they touch them. So you are hearing that. Lily writes, I'm sensing something in me feeling apprehensive about spending spring break with my two teenage grandchildren. That sounds like could be a big deal. Worrying about how it will be. Worrying. Something in Lily is worrying about how it will be. And Lily writes, I'm letting it know I hear that. Beautiful. So something's worried, but that doesn't mean you are worried. You are the one who can hear the worries. This disidentification, as we call it, or unmerging, is so powerful. Because if I'm worried, I'm anxious, I'm afraid, I'm tense, then there's nobody here. There's nobody left over to be with those feelings. It's about company. It's about not leaving our feelings to be alone. It's so much not about getting distance from them. I wouldn't call it distance at all. I would call it being present, being with, giving company. Yes, yes. Elizabeth writes, I'm sensing something in me is in physical pain. Yeah. You know, physical pain is interesting because if it's chronic pain, if it's a pain you felt in that same place before, then it has a different kind of message for you than the tension I suddenly felt as I talked about the weather. Place that's in pain may be talking to you about what it needs. And what I'd recommend with pain is that you let the word pain float away for a while. Pretend you don't have the word pain in your vocabulary anymore, just for a little while. We'll need it back later. And then sense how you would describe the sensation as if you had never felt it before. You might find that very interesting. Catherine, something in me feels trapped. Seeing the mounds of snow outside my door. Okay, that one's about weather too. And you're sensing something and you feel trapped and let it know you hear it. And that would be one where you would say, no wonder. No wonder. No wonder is like super empathy. When you say no wonder to how you're feeling, there's even more empathy. It's not the same as totally agreeing with it. There's still more of you than that. But it's You know, imagine saying to a friend who's telling you about a hard time, you know, no wonder. It feels good to hear, doesn't it? So our parts like it too. Yeah. Agnes, sensing tightness in the belly. Great, Agnes. Good. And now being open to what it's showing you, what it's connected to, what more it feels. Yes. And Catherine, about the feeling trapped, about the snow, the shoulders are telling her they don't want to shovel any more snow. Big no wonder there, Catherine. Yes. Hans Jorgreid, something in me is afraid that a project will be shipwrecked and I'll be the one to blame. Uh-huh. So feeling that in your body, letting it know you hear its worry, the project will be shipwrecked and that you'll be blamed. And maybe that gives us a breath. You know, our theme for today, although I haven't mentioned it yet, is about why being calm matters. And Hans Jorg's example is perhaps a really good one, because that's a situation with a customer. And probably there are some actions that could be skillful actions, wise actions, ways of dealing with this that you may not know what they are yet. And of course, I don't know what they are. But as you acknowledge the feelings about this, the worry that the project's going to get shipwrecked, and other worries that you'll be blamed, right? That was the other worry. And that begins to be heard inside of you. And there's a greater sense of calm that comes from that. Then your body starts to calm in general. And what happens then is you have more access to a wider range of possible actions. Maybe you hadn't been realizing you could ask somebody for help with this. Or maybe you hadn't been realizing there's some protection you could give yourself by making a certain documentation, perhaps. I don't know. I'm not even sure what business you're in. I kind of forget. But we get smarter because we can see more possibilities when we can be present with our feelings instead of being merged with our feelings. And that ability to have more ideas, more possibilities arises naturally when we're calmer, when we're more the big space instead of being the feelings. And that's what we need. I mean, in stressful times, we may need more of the resources of our intelligence because we may be confronted with more things that are hard to deal with. So better to do the process of being with how we feel, acknowledging it. You know, sometimes there's a part of me, maybe you too, that wants to say, I don't have time to acknowledge my feelings. I have too much to do. Well, here's the trouble with that. By not acknowledging my feelings, I stay at a higher level of stress. And then what I'm doing with my time is maybe not as efficient. So it actually may not be a way of saving time. If I can spend some time, 20 minutes, like we're doing today, being with what we feel, the body becomes more available for the interactions and processes that you need to do today. Just checking the chat again. Yeah, Andrea writes, I'm sensing something in me that fears. And I'm sensing it's hard to be fully present and there's many conflicting thoughts and messages within. You know, Andrea, When you notice it's hard to be fully present, that's a very present thing to do. So good for you. And that, I love that. That's good news. That noticing that it's hard to be as much present as I would like, just doing that noticing helps me come a bit more into the present. So well done. I just love this process because there's so much good news by being aware, by noticing, by sensing. I'm expanding my ability to be present, to be wise, to be who I fully am. It's just so nice. Melanie writes, if we let go for a word, the word pain for a moment, what is it again? Okay, here's what you said. Don't have the word pain anymore. Let's call it a sensation. It's a more neutral word. So this sensation, whatever it is, I'm letting go of the word pain and I'm describing it freshly. Just going to write this in the chat. I'm describing it freshly as if I had never felt it before. And that fresh description might be uncomfortable. Let me tell you a story that I love. This is kind of a miraculous story, so we don't have that same expectation from every situation. But here's what happened to a friend of mine who's a focusing teacher, long time ago when pharmacies were not open 24 hours. Well, maybe they're not even open 24 hours anymore. Anyway, client of his said, I ran out of pain medication and my shoulder is hurting terribly. I don't know what to do. Can you give me a focusing session? And this was a long, long time ago when nobody thought focusing could help with physical pain. But my friend didn't want to let that stop him. So he did a session with this guy and he said, so your shoulder's in pain. All right. So let's not use the word pain. Let's just be with the sensation in the shoulder and let a description or an image come freshly for what it feels like right now. Okay. So the guy paused and he said, you know what it feels like? It feels like 1,000 arrows are piercing my shoulder. Doesn't sound much better than pain, but it was fresh. It was something he felt right now. It was the right now description for what it was like. And in the next moment, he says, they're arrows of anger. Like that was the new step that came because he had described it freshly. And about a minute later, he said, the pain is gone. Now, that's a miracle story. It happens sometimes. But some openness to that possibility can occur if we change the word pain to the word sensation and then describe it freshly. That's right. Very good. Oh my gosh. We are nearly done. Heather writes, floating and acknowledging the pain brings back the panic. It's a potentially old pattern involving my business partner, ex-husband. So I'm acknowledging that now. Yeah. Owen Hunsjörg wrote, my heart warms and I have ideas to protect myself. That's what we were hoping. This was about the business, feeling worried he'd be blamed. Yes. Great. Great. Well, what have we done today? We've paused, spent time with the body which has so many gifts, always ready to tell you what needs attention, and pausing to be with how you feel, using I am sensing something in me feels, is the magic. It is coming into the present. It enables you to give your whatever's going on in you, all the company it needs. You say no wonder to what you're discovering. And then you have fresh possibilities because of your calmer mind, your calmer body. So wishing you well. May you have a great day, great week, a great month. I'm doing this again in 1 month. Take care. Thank you so much for being here. Bye for now. Just looking at the thank yous. Bye for now.